Welcome back. In this tutorial, I will show you how to create a streetwear poster design concept with less element and GIMP. Let's begin. Go to File, New, and change the width to and the height to. This is the Instagram portrait photo size, and click OK. And in the background layer, fill it with the black color. You can go to here, or the shortcut is Shift B. And make sure you change it to the black color and just click on the canvas. Next, I'm going to add the guides. So to add the guides, you can easily drag from the left to here. Add again. Make sure you turn on the view and show guides, or the shortcut is Shift Ctrl T. Add more, you can add from the top. Right, let me change this to move tool for easier when you move the guides. I usually set up layout first when creating a poster in game. It will make you easier when you add some element in this canvas. And then add some image in file. Open this layer and adjust this. Set convert. You can scale it down by pressing Shift S. And hold control while scaling to keep the proportional scale, so you don't want it stretched or like this. Just hold control while scaling. Alright, then press enter. So now I'm going to add the Duotone effect. So the Duotone effect is the two contrast color that blend in this one image. Let me show you what I mean. Now we're going to change the color in black and white. So go to color, desaturate, and just desaturate again. And just click OK. So let's create a selection by going on this layer, the image layer, by right click, all parts of selection. And while in selection like this, create a new layer and name it for the color 1. And you can change the color to what you like. Just this pink, or you can see this color code. Right, just hit OK. And while in selection, you can go to edit, just fill with foreground color. And deselect it and select none, or the shortcut is Shift Ctrl A. And let's change this color mode to difference. Alright, so you can see these the two color, the turquoise and this red or the brown color. And duplicate this color one to click this icon and change the layer name by double click and rename it to the color 2. You can still adjust the color in colors, hue and saturation. Let's find the color as you like. Okay, I'm going to keep this color, maybe increase the lightness a little and decrease the saturation. So this is the lovely vibrant color, the yellow and the purple. I'm going to place the image in the right position with move tool, or the shortcut is M, and make it link these three layers. So when you move, it will move all of these three layers. So you don't want the result like this. That's why we need to link the layers. Next thing, to add the text element, so I'm going to press T and type, change the size to, and you can change the font to Russell 1. Try to flip it. So while you're in this text box, so right click and choose this mix orientation. And I'm going to change the color to the white. And let's flip this text by going to here, or the shortcut is Shift F. First, choose this horizontal and click, and then the vertical, and duplicate another one so you can click this icon and hold control to keep in the same line. And let's change the text color, so I'm going to this text tool, press T, just click edit. Ctrl A to select all these text. Click this color. Turn on this eyedropper tool. this purple and hit OK. Flip it again by pressing Shift F and just this vertical first and this horizontal. And now, how do we create the text with the stroke only? So in this layer, the purple text color, so right click, output to selection, go to select and choose shrink. Just make it by 1 pixel. So the selection will move inside the text. And while in selected like this, press delete on the keyboard. Then deselect it in select and choose none, or the shortcut is Shift Control A. If it's too dark, you can increase the lightness in colors, hue and saturation. Try to increase the lightness. That's it. And I'm going to add the period, so with text tool, press T and type the period button. Change the size to 200. Change the font to the Russo one. Change the color same as this purple and hit OK. And you can change the orientation, so in this text box, right click, choose the from left to right. So this is the normal type. Take the dot and place it on here. Tips for you when you're working with the text in GIMP, don't try to resize it with the Shift S. Right, or you will lose the quality. Let's see. So it will create these blurry lines. The best way to do it is press T to activate the text tool and click. You see this dialog box, just hit edit and try to resize it, example 300. So you will keep the sharp quality of the text. And if you want to flip it, press Shift F and click. So the quality is still sharp. And I'm going to add more text, press T and type. Just going to duplicate this. Let's create a rectangle. So create new layer, animate for the rectangle. And click this rectangle tool, or the shortcut is R. And block around the text. And make it with the stroke only with white color, so you can flip this color. And go to edit, stroke selection. Make it by 2 pixel and click stroke. Alright, deselect it and select none. And add more rectangle to here. So I'm going to create new layer and name it rectangle gradient. With rectangle tool again, create a selection, fill it with the gradient color. So I'm going to change the gradient color to this yellow and the purple, and change this white color to this purple, for example, and flip, change this red color to this yellow color. With gradient tool, or the shortcut is G. Make the shape in linear, click, and try to create a gradient. So you can adjust the gradient in this node and press enter. Deselect it and select and choose none. Add more text, I'm going to press T and just paste the text. You can type the text and place it on here. So you can move this text by unlink the previous layer. And move down. And add more text here, press T and type. And change the font to Anten. Increase the text to 100. Place it on here, change the text to white. And make it with stroke only by right click, output to selection, and go to select and choose shrink. Just make it by 1 pixel, then hit OK, and press Delete. And deselect it with Shift-Ctrl-A. Add more text, so I'm just going to duplicate this text. Oops, don't forget to unlink. Change the color. Change the text to Russell 1 again. Change the size to 22. Change the text color to this yellow. Let me change this text color to this more bright color. And this, move it down a little. And you can see the result by going to View and turn off the guides by pressing Shift-Ctrl-T. Okay. I think I want to move this area to the top a little. So I'm going to link this and this awaken text and the dots. Select one linked layer and move it up by holding Ctrl. Before end of this video, I'm going to add the texture in File, open this layer. You can download this texture in the link in the description below and click Open. And resize it by pressing Shift S, hold Ctrl only to create a proportional scale, and press Enter. And change layer mode to Divide. Right, you can see this folded paper texture. And I'm going to duplicate the texture, so I want to this black color with the paper texture. So duplicate the layer. And on this, change layer to Normal. And place it to the bottom, above the background. Nice combination. You can try some experiment with this like background. So we're going to make it darker in color, curves, and just turn it down. Just keep the paper texture. So just turn it down again. Nice, but it looks like the brown paper. Desaturate this in color, desaturate, and just desaturate again. And hit OK. There you go, the black paper texture. And you can turn on the opacity if it's too much. And last thing, to add the noise, so create new layer and emit noise. Reset the color, you can click this black and white color and fill it with the black color. And go to Filter, Noise, just the EHV noise. Let's try to increase it. The value, the saturation, and the dulling. And change the mode to Screen. You can reduce the opacity. That's it. I hope you learned something new, how to create this kind of poster by using dark color as the background and the texture. That's the key. I'm Zakey from Zakey Design. Create something good today. Thanks for watching.